In this video, we're going to contrast the difference between water alkalinity and the pH of the water and how those directly influence the pH of your growing media. When discussing the difference between water pH and alkalinity, let's start out by defining what these terms mean. pH is a measure of the amount of acidity in the water. So as an example, the more acidic the water is, the lower the pH is, and vice versa, the higher the pH, the more alkaline the water source is. Water pH is important because it definitely indicates or dictates the solubility of the micronutrients present in the water. So for instance, if you're growing hydroponically, the pH of the water is critically important because that is, shall we say, your growing media from which your plants will actually obtain their nutrients from. In contrast, alkalinity is a measure of the bicarbonate and carbonate content in the water itself. Think of bicarbonates and carbonates as the limestone content in the water. Certainly, the higher that is, the faster your pH of your growing media climbs. The lower it is, your fertilizer and other inputs have greater influence over the pH of your growing media itself. As you can see on your screen, this chart shows the influence of water alkalinity and how acid neutralization takes place as far as reducing that alkalinity. If we take a look at our initial pH of our two water sources, we have one that starts out with an initial pH of 9.3 and the second one at 8.3. We add sulfuric acid to bring down the pH of both water sources to 5.8. But notice that the amount of acid required is four times different. So for instance, in the first water source, you're bringing it down 3.5 units from 9.3 to 5.8, requires 16 ounces of acid to do that. In the second one, it requires 69 ounces to basically drop less of a unit, which is 2.5 pH units. If we contrast out the last column, the alkalinity, we can see that the alkalinity of the water directly relates to the amount of acid required to bring the pH of that water down to 5.8. So again, it's not the pH of the water that dictates how much acid is required, but it's the alkalinity that dictates how much acid is required to bring the pH of your water down to a certain point. In the second chart that's on the screen, here we're looking at how water alkalinity influences the pH of the actual growing media. Now, as I mentioned before, water pH is important when it comes to growing hydroponically, but when it comes to growing media, the pH of the water and the pH of the growing media have absolutely no relationship. But it's the water alkalinity that has direct relationship on the pH of the growing media. So as an example, if we look at this chart, we can see that there's basically three different treatments of three different water types. So the first one, the water alkalinity is zero, which is nothing. The next one is 200, which is kind of high. And the third one is an alkalinity of 270. So we take a vinca crop, we're watering it in with fertilizer on a constant basis of 13:2:13, and tracking after 7 weeks to see what happens to the pH of that growing media. As we can see, the starting point is the same for all three. The red bar on the left shows it starts out at 5.3. But as we see over time, the pH does go up in all three samples because of the fertilizer, the water itself, and also the limestone charge. But notice that the alkalinity has a direct impact on the overall ending pH after 7 weeks. So we can see as an example, in the first water source, your water pH goes up, or your growing media pH goes up about 1 unit. The second one, it goes up almost 2, and the third one, it goes up a little bit over 2. So again, the higher the water alkalinity, the faster the pH of your growing media climbs. So water alkalinity directly impacts the pH of your growing media. However, the water pH has absolutely no impact on the pH of the growing media. Thank you.
For more information, visit our website. Follow us on social media.